foundation inspection. So the rear and the right elevation of the property, the foundation, is in good order. We're at the front elevation of the foundation. I'm now at the left elevation. It's all looking pretty good on the day of the inspection. Foundation's performing as expected. This is the foundation level measurement. It's starting off in the corner of the breakfast nook, and I've zeroed the meter. As you can see, we have a reading here of zero. This is a great inspection. What we're looking for is good sloping away from the actual foundation itself. We want to see good drainage. We are at the right front corner of the property. This is the front yard, and you can see we have nice drainage here, nice drainage on the right elevation. Let's go to the rear elevation now, and we should see a similar type of grading that allows the ground to dry. This is very important in Texas because we have what we call expansive soils. These expand and contract with the moisture that's content. Good grading allows the area to dry. Now here we've got a drop away here. It's not quite as much as I would like to see it, but it's going to drain. We've got good swale here, and we've got a good area here on the side. Let's look at the left-hand elevation of the property. Yeah, and we've got great grading on the left-hand elevation. The property should drain very adequately. This is the roof inspection. I'm performing it from the ground because the roofs are very steep. This is a very steep climb. It's 1 in 12. It goes up a hell of a slope here. That is really a good benefit because what it allows the water to do is shed it from the roof very quickly. Roof sheds water. We're particularly interested in the flashings around here. Are they done correctly? The flashing here is okay. We've got counter flashing and step flashing. Up on this side of the roof here, it's looking good. Let's go and look at the rear elevation. Again, nice sloping roof. Flashings are all correct around here. Up here we have the chimney, and it has a chimney cricket. All the other penetrations, the flues, go above the roof line, which is very good. It means gases coming out of there are going to be blown away in the wind. It's what we like to see. But we have a problem with the flashing at the rear elevation here. Just this in this area here, that needs to be repaired. I'm now at the left-hand elevation. Again, looking at the roof. In good order. This is the attic inspection. We're looking at general construction details of the attic. Thank you. fireplace inspection. What we're looking for is correct construction. This is a manufactured fireplace, so it's installed, built in the factory, installed here. And very simply, what we need to make sure is that the damper, which is above us here, works. This survey of the doors, what we're looking for, we've got Wenseal, which we have got. We've got a good threshold. And that the door actually locks. There we go, it does. Excellent. That was the rear yard door. This is the front door. Again, we want to make sure we've got good weather sealing around it. It has. We've got a good threshold, it's in good condition. Sealed, excellent. Shut the door. And it locks, excellent. And I've got to find the garage. It's around here somewhere, I won't. This is garage door, there's a seal all the way around, and we've actually got a threshold, and we make sure the door locks. It does. This is a window inspection. What we're looking for is the correct installation of windows. Above here we've got weep holes, which is correct, and around the windows we've got good caulking. See, it's all the way around. I've been around the whole of the house and the caulking is in good condition. Now, one tip when you move in, make a note that in about a year's time, maybe 2 years, you're going to have to re-cork all the windows because the Texas sun gets so hot. I mean, it really does get hot and it cooks the caulking, and the caulking is very important. But as of the day of the inspection, all the caulking is looking in good order. This is the internal of the panel. What we have is a grounding bar here and a neutral bar here. And one of the important things is that they're not actually bonded in the sub-panel. This is the sub-panel. This is the main panel. And as you can see here, we have a bar. It's a bonding bar. It goes between the two, and that's correct. So all is correct with the electrical wiring on the day of the inspection. This is the electrical panels. We have two panels. In this panel here, we have the arc fault detectors. They're mandatory nowadays. There's one for every bedroom. And over here we have the main panel. We're going to have a look inside. This is a gas detection test. Check and find out if we've got gas leaking into the attic. Currently the furnaces are running. And we're checking these lines, making sure they're sealed. And it's all in good order. Heater is just about to come on. You see the heater there. That's okay. So far so good. No gas leaks either on the furnaces or the water heaters. This is your water heater. The air conditioning compressors on the exterior. We have the air conditioning running at the lowest temperature. We're going to test its efficiency. Make sure it drops the temperature properly. These units are in good condition. Fitted correctly. Let's transition to the wall. Good insulation here. And good insulation into the wall there. So that's in good order. Both the units are level. So we're measuring the temperature across the plenium. We're currently looking at the return. We've got a return here of 73. So the air going back to the air conditioner is at 73. The air coming from the conditioner is 57, 56, 56 minimum. So we've got a drop from 73. On the day of the inspection, I was unable to get both the heaters to work. I switched them on at the controllers, then came up to examine them and inspect them. I waited while the ceramic heaters come on, they've come on and turned off, and neither lit. So both furnaces, both heater furnaces, currently are not working. It's a gas hob, four of the burners light, the one at the back here doesn't, it's missing the actual flame cover. That needs to be in place before it will light. This is the water meter. What we're looking at is the notulating meter, and it's slowly coming into focus because we've got such bright light here. You can see that little red triangle there. Now the water in the house, all the water's turned off, and that is not turning. Now if that was turning, it would indicate that we have a water leak somewhere in the house. So I've been looking at this for about, on and off for about 5 minutes. There's no turning there, there's no numbers changing. So I can confirm on the day of the inspection, there were no water leaks inside the house. We're about to conduct the water flow test. What we want to know is if we've got good functional flow. You simply do that by turning on the tub. So the tub's now flowing, got the hot and cold water flowing into it. Nice flow into there. Now, as that is on, we should also be able to turn the shower on. And there should be sufficient water coming out of the shower, even with the tub running, to take a shower. And if you look there, we have a nice bit of flow there. This is hydrotherapy tub. They're running the jet. As you can see, they're all operating. This is the water pressure test. We're actually inside the house in the laundry room. And we have a pressure of 50 pounds per square inch. We like the pressure. Well, the pressure has to be between 40 and 80. So 50 pounds per square inch is good. Good pressure. This is zone one of the irrigation system. It runs down the left-hand elevation of the house. And it's running perfectly. This is zone three of the irrigation system. It's the rear yard. All heads in. Sorry, this is zone 2, not zone 3. Zone 2, the rear yard, and it's running. This is zone 3 of the irrigation system. All the heads are up and working. This is zone 4. The heads are all running perfectly. Good coverage. This is zone 5 of the irrigation system. Right-hand elevation of the property. All the heads are up, and it's working. This is zone 6, all heads are up, operating perfectly. This is zone 7, all heads are up, running perfectly. This is zone 8, all heads up, working perfectly. We have a zone 9 displayed on the controller, currently it's not running. I can only guess, can't be sure, definitely. But I believe it's the irrigation system for the two trees in the front yard. There's no water coming out, and I've not seen water coming out, so I can only assume it's attached to zone 9, and that's not operational. So zone 9 on the sprinkler system, not operational.